Hello students, today we are going to implement bottom-up parsing. Objective of this experiment to make aware about shift-reduced parsing technique. After successful completion of this experiment, you will be able to implement bottom-up parsing technique. Figure shows the different type of parsers. So bottom-up parser is again a simple shift-reduced parser is a form of bottom-up parser. So but shift-reduced parser today we are going to implement. Let us discuss the basic concept. Shift-reduced parsing is used to construct a parse tree for an input string, beginning at the leaves bottom and working up towards the root. So it is a process of reducing string W to the start symbol of a grammar. Let us see the example. So for a given grammar, S produces AABE, A produces ABCB, and B produces D. Bottom-up parsing, it is the reverse of rightmost derivation. In the figure you can see, S produces AABE. Again, the rightmost non-terminal is B. So B produces D. So the non-terminal, rightmost non-terminal is A. So A is replaced with A, B, C, and again the rightmost non-terminal is A, so A is replaced with B. As in every step, rightmost non-terminal is replaced with right-hand side part of a production. So on every step, rightmost derivation is written RM. RM stands rightmost derivation on the arrow. As I talked, bottom-up parsing, it is the reverse of rightmost derivation. So when we go in reverse order, in every step, a substring of a given string is to be reduced with non-terminal, and finally we reach to the start symbol. So these are the steps to reduce W to start symbol. So initially the B is reduced by non-terminal A. Then ABC is reduced by non-terminal A. Then D is reduced by B. So A produces D. And finally, this A is reduced with AAB. So A, sorry, S is reduced with A, B, and E. So B, A, B, C, D, and A, B, E. These substrings, these are the handles. Okay. So in every step, handles are to be reduced with non-terminal symbol. So, in the implementation of shift-reduced parsing, there are four possible actions: shift, reduce, accept, and error. So, parser is either going to do the shift operation, means push operation; reduce means pop operation. Okay. So in the shift action, the next input symbol in the string is shifted onto the top of the stack. In the reduce action, right end of the handle on the top of the stack is replaced with non-terminal. In the accept action, the parser announces successful completion of parsing. So in this action, parser generates, parser stops the parsing as it accepts a given string. In error action, the parser is going to identify syntax error and generate an error recovery routine. It shows a very simple example. Assume that the grammar is E produces E plus E, E star E, E and ID. And the given string is ID 1 plus ID 2 into ID 3. So pointer is now pointing to very first symbol in the input string. Now the top of the stack is dollar, and dollar is not a valid handle, right? So the shift is done. So ID 1 is shifted, pushed to the stack, on the top of the stack. Now again, the ID 1 is a valid handle, right? Because E produces ID. So reduce action is performed by the parser. So ID is reduced with E, reduced by E. Again, E is not a valid handle, right? So again, shift is carried out, means plus is pushed onto the top of the stack. Again, ID 2 is pushed. So the top of the stack is a valid handle because there is a production which produces the ID. So E produces ID. So reduce action is performed by the parser. Okay. So in this way, finally, whenever on the top of the stack is a start symbol and the current input symbol is a dollar, parser accepts a string and stops parsing. Okay. So the last step is to draw the parse tree. So the very first action is reduce. So ID. Fine. ID is reduced by non-terminal E. Then again the ID is reduced by non-terminal E. Again, the ID is reduced by non-terminal E, right? Fine. Then again, ID E is reduced, E plus E is E star E is reduced with reduced by non-terminal E. So E star E. And finally, E plus E is reduced by E. So E plus E is reduced by E. In this way, the parse tree is constructed. Now let us see what are the inputs, outputs, and the data structure is required to implement bottom-up parsing. So we need input buffer for storing the input string, and the stack data structure is required to store and access production rules. The very simple case is, suppose the sample input is ID 1 plus ID 2 into ID 3, and the grammar is E produces E plus E, E star E, E and ID. Then the output should be configurations of shift reduce parser on the input ID 1 plus ID 2 into ID 3. So let us see the demo. I have already compiled a code, so let me run it. id plus id id plus id into id 3 and yes, you can see the output which includes a table, action, three columns are there, stack, input and action. So the output should be the configurations of shift redis parsers on input id 1 plus id 2 into id 3. So this is all about experiment number 9. Thank you very much.